Hey everyone, this is Nikki with Yoga at Glance. I have not been posting lately because I've been trying to get the echo out of my space, and I found some tips on how to do that, but I'm back, and I will try to post something every Thursday, a different posture, and maybe even a flow. So today's posture that we're going to learn today is called Lizard. Lizard pose is a pose that a lot of people really do, and they don't even realize they're doing it, even if they're not practicing yoga, to open up the hips. Why open up the hips? Well, opening up the hips will help you with your lower back issues or relieves back issues. It will also help you with your stabilizers, because that's where your hips are. Your hips are your stabilizers. That's what helps you bend, that's what helps you run, that's what helps you with a lot of different mobility. So generally your hips are extremely tight if you sit all day, or if you are in a situation where you're driving all the time, or you're working out and you're not stretching. And that's another thing, your hip mobility will help you at the gym. So we're going to go ahead and try to see if I can show you some steps to get into lizard pose today. Now, a couple of things. You might want to use a block. And if you don't have a block, you can use a book, or you can use anything that's stackable. But you can get your blocks somewhere at Amazon, or you can get it at Walmart. They range from about $5 to $20. So that's all you really pretty much need is yourself and your mat. Now, hips are definitely a very sensitive spot, so you really want to make sure you stretch pretty well. So we're going to start standing. So our intention today is to get our hips to open up a little bit. So let's just inhale here into your core. And then as you exhale, you want to hinge at your hips, not from your spine. And if you notice, I'm hinging right at my waistline, not dumping all the way into my upper back or my lower back. And I'm still breathing. Conscious breaths. And that can be inhaling into your nose and out of your nose, or that can be inhaling into your nose and out of your mouth. Now, hips also helps your hamstrings. So you can't work your hips without really working your hamstrings. So I'm coming to my little fold here. Now, if you have your block, your block is just a method of bringing the floor closer to you, because I want you to keep that hip hinge, and you'll notice the glutes will push back. You want to really hinge forward as you lengthen. Now, I tend not to grab onto the block because the floor is not something you can necessarily grab onto, so you want to keep your hands nice and flat on the top. Now this is the first stage if you really, really have a tight, tight back. The second stage, you're going to come to here and keep the length of this line. You're still breathing in through the crown of your head and then exhaling all the way down to the lower back. Inhaling and exhaling. If that's too easy, you may want to bring it down a notch. And then further, you can bring your hands to your shin, you can bring it to the thighs, but you want to look like a table. So you can really get that stretch in your hamstrings. So here we are. Your chest is lifted. And you should really feel the hamstrings engaged and on fire if you're pressing forward. We're now going to come into the full fold. What we're going to do is we're just going to walk the hands all the way to the top of the mat four times. So, one, two, three, four. keeping the integrity of the spine coming into a downward facing dog. Now, if your hamstrings are tight, your heels will go up. But you want to keep the spine long. You want to keep the shoulder blades broad, the collarbone broad, and you want to breathe through this downward facing dog, inverted V. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. And I'm just basically visualizing my breath going down my hamstrings. And up and down the hamstrings as I inhale. And keeping the hips up high, really feeling a good stretch there. We're going to come into lizard, so you can either sweep the right leg up into a three-legged dog. But if that's not in your practice, you can just step that right foot right between the elbows of your hands. Very important here. The knee is bent right on top of that right ankle. Take your right hand, place it onto the inside of that right foot. Heel toe the right foot away from your body, creating space. Now drop. You want to slide that left leg all the way back towards the middle of your mat and then soften all five toes onto the earth. Keeping the integrity of your spine. You want to find the length. We tend to look down and round through the spine, which leaves an imprint on the spine. So you want your wrists and your shoulders in alignment. You want your knee and your ankle in alignment. So I'm going to move back here. Now, as long as you're in alignment, you're in the first stages of your lizard pose. Now, the feet, the right foot, you can walk in towards the top of your mat, but never walk it inward. You want to let the right knee kind of open up, soften to the right side. So if you push the foot over towards the top of the mat, as you notice my foot was there initially, you're headed towards your split. But if not, you want to just keep it in alignment with the ankle and just create that space as you breathe in and breathe out. And notice my spine alignment. My spine is in still full alignment. Now, you can always use your block to help you bring the floor a little closer to you to keep the length in the spine. Maybe that's going to be a little bit easier. You still want to allow that right knee to soften to the right side. And you're breathing in through the crown of your head and exhaling down to the lower back. Breathing in and breathing out. Maybe about 5 to 10 breaths. Breathing in and breathing out. If you feel any discomfort on that left knee, maybe put a little towel or maybe a soft pillow or something just to help you allow a little more cushion, maybe double up on your neck. Remember, you're breathing in, breathing out, still keeping your neck soft and in full alignment. Now, the progression here is to bring your left forearm down to the earth or onto that block. And you can either wrap your right hand around that right ankle, maybe sweep it behind, and really press towards the earth. Remember, you're still allowing that right knee to just kind of collapse there to the right. You're really letting it just kind of fall and do whatever it wants to do. Maybe you want to bring the right forearm down to on top of the block. Now, if it's in your practice and you feel like your hips are just a little more open than normal, it's okay to progress and move the block away. Remember, keeping the integrity of the spine. You start as you inhale, lengthen, and exhale. It could be exaggerated. I actually prefer exaggerated instead of internal. Listen to the breath as you inhale, and maybe exhale on the side. And then start with your left forearm and bring it down to the earth. Now, when you bring the forearm down to the earth, you want to make sure your elbow is stacked on top of that left shoulder. And you want to keep the core engaged. You don't want to collapse into your shoulders. Keep all 10 fingers spread apart for stability. And it's just good practice, especially when you're coming into crow. As you breathe into the crown of your head, really find the length in the spine. Let that right knee open up through the hips. Inhale, lengthen into the spine. And then exhale. Inhale and exhale. Same here, you can always wrap your right arm around that right ankle, maybe lengthen it. Inhale and exhale. Sometimes I like to take a twist as I sweep the right arm up, really stretching out that iliopsoas muscle that wraps right down the lumbar spine. As I breathe in and breathe out, maybe sweeping the right arm right over the ears, giving a nice stretch in the shoulders, and then exhaling as I sweep the right hand down. Lengthen on the inhale and exhale all the breath down the lower back. Pressing up, take your time as you press up. And then tuck that back foot in. Lift the left knee up. Remember, keep the spine long. And then step the right leg back. Downward facing dog. Keeping the hips up high. So this is high hips, but up. And then press back. If the heels are up, that's fine. You want to use your breath for movement. Using the breath to help you move. So you want to keep the priority in your spine. Nice and long. Breathing in and breathing out. Let's walk our hands back 4 times to our feet. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Back to our Ardha Uttanasana. Half lift. Maybe your hands are on the block, so keep it close by. Maybe your hands are on your hip, your shins. Maybe your hands are on your thighs. And then on your next in-breath, let's float our arms up. And on your exhale, bring the thumbs to heart center. So there you have it. Lizard pose. Just make sure you do both sides. 5 to 10 breaths is good to allow the hips to open and create space in those hips to gain hip mobility, more hip mobility to relieve your lower back issues, and to just help you progress a little further in your squats, in your daily lunges, and just in your daily functions. Even when you get out of, you know, every day when you go home, make sure you take the time to stretch out those hips. Or early in the morning before you get out and set the tone for the day, clear that space in that second energy center. So I leave you with just a note, just remember that, you know, everything is progress and everything is a process. Just takes a little bit of patience. Your hips didn't become tight overnight, so it's not going to open up overnight. So remember, just take a little patience, a little practice, a little process. So enjoy that, and then you will definitely see the progress. So thank you for joining me this afternoon, or whatever time of day it is in your region of the world. And thank you for sharing space with me. I'm back on YouTube, remember, every Thursday. And if you like this video, please subscribe. If you like the video, press the like button. If you have any comments or suggestions, by all means, leave a few there. I am welcome to any feedback. Thank you again for sharing space with me. And I am also on Instagram and Facebook. Yoga at a Glance. And I leave you with,